Namaste. A hiring of a wrong bodyguard can make all the difference between life and death. Am I right? Similarly, in organizations, agar ek galat insaan hire kar liya, it can make a huge difference. So as an entrepreneur or as a leader, you got to be very clear about the kind of clarity you have about a position for which you want to hire somebody. Aksar entrepreneurs ka questions nahi hote. Main to hamesha apne workshop mein bolta hu mazak ke roop mein ki entrepreneurs ke paas normally teen questions hote hain. Pehla question hota hai jab wo interview lete hain ki kahan kaam kiya. Second question hota hai kyun choda. And third question, which is actually the defining question for them, whether they will take the person or they will not hire the person, is kitna lega, what salary you expect. And the decision is made most probably on the last question. The first two are formality based questions ki kuch to puchna hai, we can't jump on to the salary part directly. Well, humor aside, I feel that taking interviews is the most wonderful part of being in an organization. But before you take an interview, you got to understand that there are two aspects to a job. One is the capability side and second is the willingness side. And when the person gives a CV to you, the biodata of the person is in front of you. In that CV, you will see that there are two parts. There's the education side of the person and there's the experience side of the person. And most of the times, entrepreneurs, they ask questions based on these two aspects. Ki tune padhai kahan kari hai? Tune experience kya hai? That is already there in the CV. And most of the interview revolves around that. So you have to move on to the two other aspects of the interview, which you have to prepare yourself for. The other part is, ki competency kya chahiye? Ki aapke hai wo, suppose a salesperson hai, to salesperson ke liye competency kya lagti hai? Now, the person who comes in may have a competency in sales from a different aspect because he was working in a different company. Aapki company alag hai. So you have an opening for a production manager. So what competency is required? Are we clear about it? Second part is, what personality traits are required for the person to become successful in that role in the company? कि अगर वो salesperson हमारे यहाँ है, तो हमारे यहाँ वो salesperson के लिए क्या personality traits लगेंगे, जिससे वो कामयाब हो जाए? ये clarity भी होना बड़ा जरूरी है. So before you go about hiring, I would suggest that make a list of the competencies required for a particular post. तो आप उसमें एक list बनाइए कि इसमें communication skills चाहिए, इसमें negotiation skills चाहिए, इसमें selling skills चाहिए. Depending on that position, depending on that profile, क्या-क्या competencies उस इंसान के अंदर होनी चाहिए. Second, make a list of what personality traits, what personality factors are required for the person to be successful. Or uske liye banaiye, he should be perseverant, he should have loads of confidence, he should be able to handle difficult situations. So wo kya list hai jo aapko chahiye dono ke andar. Aur jab aap interview lenge, the questions should revolve around that. Because the whole idea is ki wo insaan aa gaya aapki company mein, to aap chahoge na wo kamyab ho. To kamyab tabhi ho payega jab usko aise competency hogi ya uske paas ye personality factors honge. To if he is a fit personality wise and if he's a fit competency wise, I think then you have somebody who is a right fit for you. We're not saying the best in the world, we're saying the right fit for you. Right fit is not from the experience. Right fit is not from the education. From the education, you can have somebody from Harvard. From the experience side, you can have somebody from the world's best, but he may still not be a fit for you. So hiring is not about hiring the best. It's all about hiring the right. So if you have the right person on board, I'm sure a lot of things will fall into place. Wish you all the very best for hiring. Namaste.